A suburban tragedy has turned sinister with a 46-year-old woman charged with lighting the house fire that claimed the lives of a newborn baby and her young parents. Maggie Raworth is at the scene for us tonight. Maggie, what charges is she facing?
Tony, her name is Jenny Hayes and she's been charged with three counts of murder and arson causing death. She was arrested in Airport West this morning. Police believe she is known to either Abby or Indy, the people who died in this townhouse yesterday morning. This evening, it's quite a sombre mood. People are still slowly arriving to pay their respects to this young couple. A heartbroken sister places a toy bear at the place her sibling's young family perished.
I'm just trying to be really strong and just trying to hold it together for them.
19-year-old Abby Forrest, her 28-year-old partner Indy Sahal and their beautiful three-week-old daughter Ivy all died when fire tore through their Point Cook home.
Should be like the perfect time of their life. Now this awful tragedy has happened.
Abby gave birth to little Ivy on the same day they moved in here. Her family saying this was a young and happy couple with their whole lives ahead of them. Abby is being remembered as bold, charismatic and as an excellent new mum.
She just took to it like a duck to water and I'm so incredibly proud of her. She was absolutely smitten. She was so over the moon to become a mum.
Indipal Sahal, affectionately known as Indy, worked as a driver. His now grieving best friend says Indy was a devoted father, husband and an incredible mate.
I don't have any words for I just can't describe the sadness that I'm having now.
Today, crippled with grief, this sister and new auntie thanked the neighbours who tried to help save her family.
And I ran back and grabbed my axe from my shed. My partner rocked up and he started throwing the axe at the window, trying to actually break the window for them to get out.
Charred remnants of a young family's Australian dream. Strangers have been visiting here too, laying flowers and paying tribute to a young family taken far too soon. Neighbours are still very much in shock, reiterating just how terrifying this fire was to witness.
All I hear in my head right now is them screaming for help. And we've seen their arms, like half their body hanging out the window, trying to get out the window, but they couldn't. And then they fall back in.
The matter will be heard in the Melbourne Magistrates Court this evening. Just moments ago, I was with Indy's clearly heartbroken sister. Tony, it's hoped these charges will bring some closure to these grieving families tonight.
Terrible story, Maggie. Thanks very much for the update.